Okay, welcome to it. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to paint hydrostone or plaster castings to look like rocks. Now, hydrostone is white, has this finish. I added a pigment to this one here. So all the way through it has a gray, but there's a few tricks that you can do to make it look more like a rock. Or stone, an actual rock, something that's been chiseled instead of a piece of plaster. So what you want to do is, I use acrylic paint. You can just buy this at any art store, Roberts, Michael's Crafts, any of those places. And you just squirt some in the bag. I like to do it this way. That's about a tablespoon. And then you add some water. That's about maybe, I don't know, half a cup. Just kind of slosh it around. Now, I used to use black spray paint. And what that ended up doing was, and then you just take your piece and put it in the bag. Now, some of these I painted and treated with different things. I've been experimenting. So this one's not going to take very well, but some of these don't have anything on them, so they should take better. But anyway, when I would spray paint, you would get a flat black, and it wouldn't look like a rock. You know, maybe obsidian, but it doesn't look as believable as when you do it this way. You get different contrasts within the rock. Some parts of the hydrostone pick it up better than others. So this one here, I sprayed with a waterproof finish, so it's not going to look as good. I'll find one that I didn't spray. And the longer you leave it soaking, so as you can see here, go ahead and wipe this off a little bit. As you can see here, this one has some gray. I sprayed the top. So as you can see on the sides here, it has absorbed a lot more of the paint. And then it's only sticking in the grooves, which is also another cool effect. So we'll just set this one aside. I sprayed the top and the bottom of that one. All right, let's find one that's not sprayed. Okay, this one looks clean. This one's definitely clean. So we'll do this one here. And if it's not soaking in dark enough, you can always just add more black paint to it. And obviously, the longer you leave it sitting in, the darker it will get, the more of it will absorb. This one actually could use a little bit more black paint. So we'll just go ahead and squirt it in there. I've got it on the side up here, so we'll smear it down. Just mix it with that water. So this is really good because in a lot of times you won't be able to get it in the cracks, and I've tried toothpicks and all kinds of things, and it just really turns into a pain. But this way you get the whole thing covered. All right, so this one's a lot darker. At least it looks that way. And then just you can wipe it down. Or you can just let it sit, but I do this in multiple steps, and I'll show you what I do next. And so, certain parts of your castings, you'll notice, pick up paint a lot better than other parts just because of the way the mold was cast, or maybe you carved your master with a certain type of tool that was left a real smooth finish. So here's just a gray pigment on here. I'm gonna double bag this because there's some really rough edges at the bottom of this one and I don't trust. So I'm gonna go ahead and put two bags. I don't wanna get my clothes messy. And so then you just let it sit. Just slosh that around face down. Flip it over, let it sit. Through the bag, it looks like it's really taking on a lot of color. But we'll see when we take it out. Okay. Okay, as you can tell, this one looks a lot better. And the cool thing is, the more layers you do of this, the more contrast you'll get, the more textured it will look. It'll be a lot more believable. Now, if you really wanted, at least this is a Mayan glyph, if you really wanted this to be accurate, you would paint it white and red, but we're going for the old look, not the original look. So we'll let those set and dry, and then I'll show you the next step, and I'll do those later. All right, so they've dried, they've had some time. I've done a lot more than what I started with in the video, and as you can see, I'm wearing a new shirt because I got greedy and I tried to do a big object that I'll show you later. I got greedy and tried to do a big object in a small bag, and it just got messy and I splashed on my shirt and ruined my shirt. So I'm gonna have a nice beverage. Okay, so now that these have set and I've done a few different styles, what I do here is I just get white acrylic paint and put a blob on a paper plate in the corner, not in the middle, and then you just get a sponge, round sponge, any kind of sponge. They'll give you different textures and you can experiment with them, but I've actually found that once you use the sponge once and you kind of rinse it out, it'll get stiff, but it won't soak up as much paint and it will give it more consistent texture. So anyway, you just kind of dab a little bit on the sponge and then dab it around. Get a little more. Okay, so let's start with this one. This I did black and red on this one, and I always start on the back of the piece because there's always more paint on it initially. So I'll just kind of dab, and it might seem really stark at first, but it will blend in. Just make nice happy clouds, fluffy happy clouds. It's a Bob Ross homage. You don't know who Bob Ross is, where have you been? If you really don't know who he is, I'm sure there's a million YouTube videos. And I think he died. Pretty sure Bob Ross died. Okay, and then we'll go to the front. I always save the front till last just to kind of warm up to getting it right, and it kind of deadens the sponge and the amount of paint, so you're not glopping it on. It gives you more control And like I said, once this dries, it will look more or less brilliant on the white. But that does look pretty good, as you can see. Hold it up higher for you. That looks pretty good. Now I'll go to just a black and white one. Get a little bit more paint on here. I'm doing the flip side. Okay, now this one here, I'll do this one. This one I actually mixed some sand into the hydrostone plaster before I dumped it in the mold, and that gives it an entirely different texture. I've got some Egyptian pieces, and that was the one that I was, the big one that I was getting greedy with. I'll show another video of that one. I don't use acrylic for those. I use a very secret ingredient, and it gets in the grooves. It looks really good. But anyway, when I used sand, I used to own an art gallery, and I've never been to Egypt, but we had both versions, sand free and one with sand. And some guy came in and pointed out to the one that had sand in it. So that one looks really like what the actual glyphs look like. It was really subtle, but he noticed it. Most people I don't think would notice, but anyway. So if you want to get just a different dynamic look to your plaster castings, it does compromise the strength, but when you're dealing with wall art, it's not like it's needs to stand up to too much. Okay, and we'll do another one here. How about I do the big one? I got some paint there. Okay. Now this one I'm going to turn into a wall hanging. I'll show you how I do that in a minute. Just move that right there. Okay, so now, if it doesn't look good, you could always just paint back over it. And if you just change the color, maybe use a green or brown, it might just make it look that much cooler. Maybe like moss is growing on it. Just use the same sponge. It's kind of weak on the paint. You want to kind of mix up your patterns. You don't want to get right angles or too repetitious of an obvious paint smear, otherwise it looks fabricated. But that's also why I start on the back and then I do the sides, the least noticeable parts, before I go to the front, because that way I'm used to doing it the right way, or I'm used to how it reacts, because sometimes you get a big glob of paint. Now this glyph is a Mayan glyph, and it actually translates to mean happen. I'm gonna do this one again. I'm not getting the pop out of this. I'm not getting the contrasts that I like. So I'll do this one again, but I'll go ahead and show you what I do. I'll finish this. Just so when I do paint it again, it will have a consistent layer underneath it. So up here you can see a hand, and then a face of a monster, and then these are different characters that form the Mayan word. spots. As you can see right there, I got too big of a glob. But like I said, I'm going to paint this again. So it's not too big of a deal. Because I like to get black deep in there. And so sometimes I'll take a paintbrush. But if I get enough black into the water paint mixture, then it really seeps in there. So I might go back over that with a green once that's done as well. The bottom. Okay, so this piece here, what you do is you want to take a little frame hook, and then I use Gorilla Glue. And really, you just place where you think you can measure, but you can also eyeball it. And then squirt a dab on. I like to use these hooks and glue them on after. Some people put in little wire loops. But I don't trust this if I was to embed it into the setting plaster. So then once you lift it up, once you put it on the top, there's those two little nail holes, and that'll mark where you want it to go. And then you just put that on. What you want to do is put some tape across here. Some scotch tape is fine. Just tape it down, because with this glue, it's urethane glue, it will rise up and it will shift and move. But once that cures, I haven't had any problems, and I put some pretty heavy items up on the wall with just this combination here, the urethane glue and this type of hook. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.